God bless you. It's so wonderful to be in the house of God. Such an honor and a privilege to minister God's word. I'm reading from the book of Joshua, chapter 3, verses 1 to 7. Joshua, chapter 3, reading from verses 1 to 7. The message title this morning is Crossing Over Jordan. Last week, we spoke about the wilderness experience. We spoke about all that happens in the wilderness. How Moses said to Pharaoh, "Let my people go, so that they may worship me in the wilderness." Now that you've come to Canaan, what happens? And we're going to look at the word of God to help us through. In the book of Joshua, chapter 1, verse 1, it says, "Now after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spoke unto Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' minister, saying, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now therefore arise, go over this Jordan, thou and all this people, unto the land which I do give to them, even to the children of Israel." Chapter 3, verses 1 reading. "And Joshua rose early in the morning, and they removed from Shittim, and came to Jordan, he and all the children of Israel, and lodged there before they passed over." This place, Shittim, is the place where they sent the spies from to spy out the land. And you know the report, most of them, all of them came back and said, "We cannot take the land. There are giants in that land. It's too big for us." But right at the beginning, God said, "This is the land that I am giving to you." And it came to pass after 3 days that the officers went through the people, the host, and they commanded the people, saying, "When you see the ark of the covenant of the Lord your God and the priests, the Levites bearing it, then you shall remove from your place and go after it." Simply, what Joshua is saying, listen, you will see the Ark of the Covenant, but the priests will carry the Ark of the Covenant, and they will be 2,000 cubits away from us. That's 914 meters, almost a kilometer away. You see, here we are learning that the presence of God has to be respected. The presence of God has to be respected. Joshua says, listen, it's the presence of God that's going to take us over, but you will be a distance away because you will not desecrate the presence. Listen, the Ark of the Covenant in the Old Testament is Emmanuel in the New Testament, who is God with us, Jesus Christ. And we need to respect the house of God. We need to respect the teaching of God's word. We need to respect the presence of God. Sometimes when God is moving and everything is going the way the Holy Spirit wants it, you get one or two people in the house deciding, "I'm going to wake up and walk out at this time," and you just disturb the Spirit of God. You're not in tune with the presence and of God in the house. You can disrupt the presence. And I'll tell you how and why in a few moments. And they commanded the people, saying, "When you see the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord and the priests, the Levites bearing it, then you shall remove from your place and go after it. Yet there shall be a space between you and it, about 2,000 cubits by measure. Come not near unto it, that you may know the way by which you must go, for you have not passed this way before." I want to tell somebody in the house, if you've never passed this way before, and if you follow the presence of God, you're going to get over. Hallelujah. And Joshua said unto the people, "Sanctify yourself, for tomorrow the Lord will do wonders among you." And Joshua spake unto the priest, saying, "Take up the Ark of the Covenant and pass over the people." And they took up the Ark of the Covenant and went before the people. As we speak about the Ark of the Covenant in this message, every time we speak of the Ark, I want you to think about the presence of God. And the Lord said unto Joshua, "This day will I begin to magnify thee in the sight of all Israel, that they may know that I, as I was with Moses, so I will be with with you. Somebody say amen. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. Listen, church, you've gone through some tough times. You've gone through where the snakes have bitten you. You've gone through where you had a thirst problem. You've gone through where you did not have manna. You've gone through where you said, I want some meat. You've gone through and you said, I'd rather go back to Egypt and eat of the leeks and the garlic and the onion of Egypt. Were we not better off in Egypt? But I've got news for you. If you're camping on the Jordan and if you are waiting at the Jordan, I want to tell you this morning, you are going to pass over. Somebody say hallelujah. There was a wall of water before. There was Jordan before. And God opened up a way right there. And the sea was split in two. There's a Pharaoh that was behind you. Chariots rumbling before behind you. Snakes behind you. It was a tough call. But I'm telling you, with our Lord Jesus, He's so beautiful. You are going to make it. Hallelujah. You're going to pass over. You're going to pass over. The Jordan has been content for beautiful songs like this Welsh minister, William Williams. He wrote, when I tread the verge of Jordan, bid my anxious fears subside. Death of death and hell's destruction, land me safe on Canaan's side. Samuel Tennant of England penned these familiar words. On Jordan's stormy banks I stand and cast a wishful eye to Canaan's fair and happy land where my possessions lie. Church, just one more hill. Church, just one more valley. Church, just one more obstacle. Church, just one more death. Church, we don't know, but one thing I do know, we're going to land on Canaan's happy shore. It's going to be shortly that we're going to be on Canaan's happy shore. I don't know, as children, we sang the song, I looked over Jordan, and what did I see? Coming for to carry me home, coming for to carry me home. Listen, on the other side of Jordan, the angels are waiting to carry you over. There will be no more cancer. There will be no more pain. There will be no more disease. There will be no more heartache. The angels will come. They will embrace you and say, well done, well done. And when you meet the Master of Masters, He's going to be there seated on the throne. He's going to look at you and He will put out the scepter and He will say, well done, my faithful servant. You've come over Jordan. You've been faithful. Listen, the Jordan presents a challenge. You've come through the wilderness and you say, I've arrived. Oh no, beloved, in the Christian walk, you've never arrived. You've never arrived. You've got to follow the tenets of the faith. If ever you want to cross over, Joshua 1:2, Moses, my servant, is dead. Listen, something has to die for something new to begin. When Abraham was told by God, leave the Ur of the Chaldees and go to a land that I will show you. Abraham did not go because he was tied to his father. He was tied to tradition. And the Bible says, and Terah died. When Terah died, Abraham picked up and moved. Listen, you might be in a dark place now. You might be buried underground. Can I remind you that seed is buried underground? Can I remind you that seed is buried and it's very dark in that place? But can I tell you something? That those seeds carry the genetics to produce a beautiful tree. And if you are hidden and if you are in a dark place and if you are underground, I'm telling you, the water and the sunlight is going to bring the best in you. And you're going to germinate and you're going to grow and you're going to break through that soil. You're going to cross over Jordan, beloved. You're going to cross over the Jordan. Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody get excited as you come to this great river. I want you to know that it is in flood. Something must die. The old nature must die. The old nature must be gone. You cannot walk with the old nature when you say, I'm a new creature in Christ Jesus. I've got some pictures of the Jordan that I took. This is coming down from Mount Hermon. Mount Hermon had snow when we took these pictures. And it was snowing. And when it started to snow, the water started to come down Mount Hermon into the Jordan, and we have this beautiful picture here, most tranquil place. And when you go there, you get the fish eating at your feet. They tickle quite a lot. And so it was quite interesting and quite nice at this place. We really, really had a wonderful time. But this is the Jordan River. Show me the other pictures. We had a wonderful baptism there. You can see Juliet and Mari and Daniel and Daryl. And there were some beautiful photographs of Roy and his daughters there also. Let's more photographs of the baptism. Now, notice this river is white. And the psalmist speaks about the white of the river. And then I've got a little video clip that I want to play for you. This is a small area of the Jordan, just 10 seconds of it. Very, very small area of the Jordan. But listen, I'm not sure if you can hear the sound. Now, this is a little part of the river. Very, very small part. I took this photograph also. I'm showing off now. This is the beautiful Jordan. You know, when you stand there and you think about all of these things and you say, God, you're a wonder of wonders. You see, God's work must be done in every one of us. What happened was, as they came to the Jordan, what did they have to do? Thank you. They had to stand still. And as believers, one of the most difficult things to do is to be patient. Am I right? One of the most difficult things as a believer is to be patient. Yeah, they've come through the wilderness. They've defeated Pharaoh's army. They've got the gold from Egypt. Remember that calf that they made? They even still have the gold. They've come through. Now they stand in front of the Jordan. And here's the land that was promised to them. And God said to Abraham and to Isaac and to Jacob, I will give you the land of Canaan. And God said to Moses, I will give you the land that I promised to your forefathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. This is your land. You will take the land. I will give it to you. But they stand in front of the Jordan. The Jordan is raging. The Jordan is in flood. It's almost a kilometer wide. And they say, Jeremiah quotes and he says, that it's not so much the water of the Jordan that causes you not to get through, but it's more the entanglement underneath the foliage that is so thick that you can't get through. Yeah, the church stands and the church says, I've spent all my life, I've fasted, I've prayed, I've been dedicated, I've been through so much in my life. Now that I'm about to cross this river in my life, now that I'm about to get the other side, it is so difficult. I've got news for you if you are that one. When the Ark of the Covenant and the presence of Jesus goes before you, you're going to get on the other side. Hallelujah. You're going to make it to the other side. 3 days, they stood there and they watched this river. 3 days, they're watching this river flow by. 3 days, imagine how urgent it would have been. They had the memory of Egypt. They wondered whether Pharaoh could still come. They were talking to each other, the part of the military with them. What can we do? What can we do? What can we do? 3 days. Did God bring us to the Jordan? There we could see Canaan's happy land. But here we are on this side. How do we get across? Oh, I tell you what. When a situation seems impossible, I want to present to you a God that makes all things possible. He says, God will make a way, the song says, where there seems to be no way. You see, God will only come through when you can't see a way. If you can see the way, you'll say, I did it my way. But when God makes it happen His way, then all glory goes to Him. Is there somebody in the house that's standing at a Jordan this morning and you don't know how to get across? I've got news for you. Follow the presence of God. Follow the Ark of the Covenant. Joshua said, listen, the priests will bear the Ark of the Covenant. On the Ark of the Covenant was the mercy seat, which has the cherubims, and God's presence dwelt on the top of the Ark of the Covenant. Inside was the pot of manna. It was the rod of Aaron and the Ten Commandments. Listen, the three things, you ask yourself, why these three things in the Ark of the Covenant? I'll tell you, the Ten Commandments was there because God wanted to show the people again and again, I know your disobedience. Moses took the tablets and he broke it. Why? Because when the people came from the mountaintop, what did they see? Moses saw these people worshiping the golden calf and idol, and he broke the stones. Aaron's rod that budded. The people complained and the people grumbled. My rod is better than Aaron's rod. My rod will grow bigger than Aaron's rod. My rod will bear almonds and not Aaron's rod. God knew how people will grumble and mock and fight even in the church. The third thing that he put in there was the pot of manna. When God gave them provision, they grumbled and they said, God, we want meat. We are tired of this manna every day. You see, God took the three things that men would grumble about and he put it into the ark. And can I tell you what? He covered it with the mercy seat. Hallelujah. His mercy and his grace covers all our grumbling, covers all our nagging, covers all our fussing, covers all our ingratitude. His mercy and his grace is available no matter what a sinner you are right now. What a sinner I am. I want to tell you, thank God for his mercy and for his grace that is available to us. Hallelujah. He said, listen, stand still, wait. And you know what happened? The priests carried the ark on their shoulders. And what did the people do? They looked at what? They kept the eye on the ark. Church, take your eyes off everything else. I love the beautiful old song that says, turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face, and the things of the earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace. Keep your eye on the presence of God. As they carried the ark and they walked, these men that carried the ark, and remember, men died because they touched the ark of the covenant when they should not have touched it. And here they carry it. It is the same ark that David danced before and Michal laughed at him. And as they carried the ark, Joshua said, stand still. And they stood still. And can I tell you what happened? Suddenly they looked around and they saw the Jordan starting to dry up. Hallelujah. 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 When you apply the presence of God, I tell you what, all of your problems and your challenges and your difficulties are just going to dry up. Hallelujah. And 19 miles away from where they crossed, the water started to lump up, the Bible says. It started to mount up and create a wall. And the Bible says right from there, right up until the Dead Sea, the ground was dry. Hallelujah. And what happened? The children of Israel crossed over dry ground and entered the promised land. God said, this land I will give you. Listen, every one of you that is in the house of God, God has made a promise to you. And can I tell you that he is a promise keeping God? Hallelujah. He will never, ever, ever break his promise. Never, ever. Hallelujah. You know, I look around and I see the pain and the suffering, and sometimes I shed tears when I see people coming before me and they're crying out, you know, for help. People that have just lost loved ones. I mean, Vivian came to me this morning and she was in tears and she said, Pastor, you know, this is what happened. Kevin's nephew was shot. You know, you hear it all the time. People being killed. I saw these two ladies that belong to Scarlet Thread Church, both of them in church. And just Friday, a shooting, and both of them are just senselessly killed. This lady in Johannesburg, pulled out of car. There's so much of pain, so much of agony. Every single one of us here, every one of us has a challenge. If you don't have a challenge, then you should be dead in heaven. All of us have a challenge. Every single one of us has a challenge. And that's why I get so excited, because we're going to make it. Hallelujah. We're going to make it. Together, we're going to hold our hands, and we're going to make it to Canaan's happy shore. Hallelujah. There's a beautiful song, you know, that goes, there's going to be a meeting in the air, in the sweet, sweet by and by. I'm going to meet you over there in that home beyond the skies. Such singing you will hear, never heard by mortal ear. It will be glorious, I declare. God's own son will be the leading one at that meeting in the air. Somebody say hallelujah. It's going to be a little short time. When you look around and you see what's going on, I'm telling you, it's going to be a little while. 7.1 earthquake on the Richter scale recorded in Indonesia this past week. All over the world, earthquakes, tornadoes, political situation, the United Nations. You know what? 3/4 of the United Nations voted against Israel in this past week. Can you believe it? Yet it's the only democratic country in the Middle East, yet they voted against her. Can I tell you what? The devil hates Israel. The devil hates the church, because the devil knows that the church will be victorious. Hallelujah. We're going to make it. The church's one foundation is Jesus Christ, our Lord. A one meal is the communion. Hallelujah. Hey, church, living waters, can I tell you something? We're going to make it. Hallelujah. No matter what is before us, stand still. Watch the presence of God, and we're going to make it. But there will be challenges. God says, I will give you that city. Jericho was a mighty fortified city, and the people had closed up the city in fear of God's people, because they heard of the wonders of God's people. The moment they entered the promised land, what happened? They met Rahab. And what happened right there, the moment they crossed over Canaan? I love it. The spies said to Rahab, put a scarlet thread through your window, and you and your family will be saved. Hallelujah. When it came to Egypt, take a lamb, apply the blood on the doorpost and the lintels, and your family will be saved. Now that you've crossed over Jordan, the darling of heaven is coming down to give his blood for you. Hallelujah. And I'm going to show you that the moment you cross over Jordan, it's the blood that's going to keep you going. Hallelujah. Right on Rahab, she put on the scarlet thread. And when they saw the scarlet thread, she and her family were saved. Is there anybody in the house that needs the blood this morning? It's forever available. I love that song that says, oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the precious blood of Jesus. It's a fountain that flows from Emmanuel's veins. Don't you want to come underneath that blood and just wallow in the beauty and the sanctity and the holiness of the blood of Jesus? People don't want to talk about the blood today. They say it's too gory. We shouldn't be talking about it. But oh, the blood of Jesus, it still washes as white as snow. Hallelujah. Take that city. God said to Moses, I will give you the land. Joshua, Moses is dead. You go. And Joshua goes. And Joshua says, listen, people, all of you priests that carried the ark, you know how God stopped the Jordan. Now we're going to march around the city 6 times, once each day. I could just imagine the people of Jericho looking, what's these guys walking around? They look like fools carrying the ark around and around and around. And Joshua said to them, everyone, you will not say a word. Proverbs 18:21, life and death is in the power of the. Joshua said to all these people, you will not say a word, because they would have said, Joshua, we're walking around for nothing. Day after day, we're walking and nothing's happening. Joshua, we're tired. Joshua, we're thirsty. Joshua, we're hungry. Joshua, we crossed over the Red Sea. We crossed over Jordan to come here. Joshua. Joshua said, shh, you will not say anything. Nobody is to talk. And sometimes you need to be still. Sometimes you need not tell others your plans. Because when you tell others your plans, they never celebrate your plans. And when you have that negative input, it creates negativity. You tell only the Lord Jesus your plans. And here we have this people marching around. And on the 7th day, Joshua says to them, you will march 6 times around. On the 7th time, you will blow the trumpet and you will shout. You see, don't celebrate your victory prematurely. Wait. As a Christian, you must be patient. If the Jordan's before you and God said you're going to get on the other side and you have to wait 3 days, wait. They march once. Rahab's watching. 2. Everybody's watching. They're all locked up in the city. 3, 4, 5. They're watching this bunch of fools. 6. The 7th time they march. They march. And Joshua says, shout! And they shout. He says, blow the trumpet. They blow the trumpet. And the walls came tumbling down. Hallelujah. You see, when God says, I will give you this city, You do nothing. You do nothing about it. You know, I've read so many articles that said, oh, but it was an earthquake. Oh, yeah, it was an earthquake. But tell me, why the earthquake when they shouted and blew the trumpet? Because my God is the God of creation. Hallelujah. And then what happened? The men came and they went to the city Ai, small little city. And the spies came back and said to Joshua, Joshua, don't worry about the entire army. We'll just take a few men, 3,000, we'll go and destroy that city. God said clearly, you will not keep anything for yourself. But you know the story? Achan decided, bury some of the valuables for myself. And I told you, I'll tell you why the whole church can suffer for one or two people. And what happened was, when Achan, and this is the valley of Achor, where God took Gomer and spoke comfortably to her in the valley of Achor, called after Achan. So you see how everything's tied? And here's Achan. He hides. And you know what? They go to take the city of Ai. 36 people were killed. Why? Because there was sin in the camp. If there's sin in your home, sin in the church, sin in the family, there's a price to pay. There's a big price to pay. And I tell you what, you've got to be honest. If this house wants to be blessed, then we must go before God. We all are sinners and repent before God and say, Lord, let me not be an hindrance to my brother. Let me not be a hindrance to my sister. Somebody came and saw me this weekend and said, Pastor, I would love to come to this church, but there's this fellow I hate. I hate him. And then he realized I was quite shocked, you know. Then he said, no, I don't really hate him, but you know what? What's in your heart will come out through your mouth. Like this lady, you know, she went to the pharmacy and she told the pharmacist, I need arsenic. And he said, for what? She said, I'm going to kill my husband. He said, what? We don't give out arsenic here at this pharmacy. She says, no, please, I want it. I have to kill my husband. He has to die. I'm fed up of him. I'm sick of this man. I need the arsenic. Then he asked her, what's going on? She said, he's having an affair. He asked, with who? He's having an affair with your wife. The farmer said, I didn't know you had a prescription. How's it going, Jolene? Hallelujah. Hey, we're going to laugh our way through the Jordan, man. We're going to laugh our way over. You got your personal Jordan to cross over. God's going to see you through. God's going to take you through. Follow the presence of the Lord. Keep your respect for the presence of God. Don't do the things. Consecrate yourself, the Bible says, because the Lord will do wonders amongst you. Consecrate means to dedicate yourself, to set yourself apart. You know, the Bible says in Isaiah 51, it is your sins that have separated you from your God. You know, this week it was a comedy of errors for me. My computer crashed. I phoned Ravi, I need my computer repaired. He said, Pastor, go get it repaired. Repaired the computer. Thursday, picked it up, took it home, crashed again. Didn't know what to do. Borrowed Beverly's computer. Did my entire message, and I did a marriage seminar yesterday. And all my notes were there. That computer crashed. Now, when I asked my family, I said, somebody please lend me a laptop. They said, no, you'll crash the computer. So eventually I came to Leon. I know Leon wouldn't worry. He lent me his computer. Thank God, Leon will crash, but never his computer. So I thank God for his computer. And then I got this. You know why? God never wanted you to hear this message. Cynthia will tell you, even this morning I'm trying to print this message because I couldn't use the laptop. And then I realized I've got no Wi-Fi on that. It was such a thing. And then Leon prints a message that I did on Friday. And then I said to him, Leon, please do this. You see, the devil hates us to have victory. He wants to put us down. But you know what? In this entire week, I went through so much, but I never let the devil see my tear. Because I remember that song that says, smile through all your fears. One more valley, one more hill, and we're going to make it. Hallelujah. Just you go on for the Lord. Don't you give up. No matter what, don't give up. You might be at the brink of a miracle. Just step into the water. Stand you still. And I tell you what, when you stand still, you'll see the presence of God and what he will do for you. Then you come to Gilgal. Gilgal is a place where a lot of things happen. This is the place where they first had circumcision. Remember that they've come past, and all these men were not circumcised in the wilderness. And when they came into the land, immediately God said, circumcise them. And what does Paul say? Don't get circumcised like the Egyptians, but circumcise your hearts. Right? And the next thing they did was they celebrated Passover after 40 years. They celebrated Passover. I've got news for you. We're going to celebrate Passover after 2,000 years. You know why? Jesus said, I will not eat or drink until my bridegroom is with me again. Hallelujah. For 2,000 years, Jesus has not partaken of communion, the wine or the bread. He said, I'm waiting for my bride. Last week I said to you from the Song of Songs, so beautifully, he said, I am waiting for my lover to lean upon my bosom, who has come through the wilderness. Listen, church, when we reach Canaan's happy shore, it's then only will we be in total rest. Gilgal represents a place of rest. They had all their fight from Gilgal. But you know what the Bible says in Deuteronomy chapter 8? And when the Lord your God brings you into the land, come up, prayer worship team. And when the Lord your God brings you into the land that he swore to your fathers, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob to give you, with great and good cities that you did not build, and houses full of good things that you did not fill, and cisterns that you did not dig, and vineyards and olive trees that you did not plant, and when you eat and when you are full, then take care lest you forget the Lord, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery. When God has blessed you, don't you ever forget what God has done for you. Are you with me, church? When God has blessed you, don't you ever forget what God has done for you. Won't you just stand up? I'm going to put you into some trouble today, worship team. We're going to sing. There's going to be a meeting in the air. I know you don't know the keys. Come on, Sydney. I won't give your age now. Come on. Help me. Beverly, you can talk to me at home. All I'll do at home, I'll keep quiet. I'll say, Joshua said, I'm going to shut my mouth.
What key?
Yeah? Can we sing it? Too low, too high. Give me something low. There's too low. One up. F. Okay, you pick up, right? There's going to be a meeting in the air,
in the streets
with God and God. I'm going to meet you over there in the home beyond the sky. Start singing, you will get never heard by mortal, yeah. Will be glorious, I declare. God's own son will be the leading one at the meeting in the air.
Come on!
There's going to be a meeting in the air, in the streets with by and by. I'm going to meet you over there, in that home beyond the sky. Start thinking you will get never heard by mortal, yeah, will be glorious.
Meeting in the air, in the sweet, sweet by and by. I'm waiting.
We're going to sing this one here, right? Okay, you know this other one now. Hallelujah. Listen, church. We need to get back to those camp days. We need to get to those tent meetings, because it was there that the power of God moved. And we're going to cross over the Jordan. Hallelujah. Give me a key. Come on, Sydney. Give me a key. Fire, 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 fall on me. Fire, 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 fall on me. We're gonna make it over Jordan. We're gonna sing our way over Jordan. When I'm walking over Jordan, I wanna sing. I wanna be more and more. Come on, let's pick it up a little bit. Give me another key.
I more and more like Jesus.
I wanna be more and more like Jesus. Hallelujah. You're going to come. Anybody coming? Carry the Ark of the Covenant and walk like you don't know anybody else. Listen, put your shoulder back. Put your head up and tell the world, bring it on, baby. Hallelujah. Because the God we serve is a mighty God. He's able to keep you from falling. Don't you ever go discouraged this morning. Don't you ever go disappointed this morning. Because Jesus did not die for nothing. He died so that you and I could live an abundant life. He died so that you and I could cross over the Jordan. If you have cancer today, don't worry about it. All that will happen is you will reach Canaan's happy shore. If you have any challenge today, don't worry about it. He says, I am the God of peace. Hallelujah. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go, I will come again and receive you unto myself. That where I am, hallelujah. That where I am, hallelujah. You will be also, hallelujah. God bless you. Let's receive the benediction. Oh, glory to God. I don't want to go home today. Oh, it's so lovely to be here. Oh, it's so wonderful to be here. All our problems are gone. No nagging, no fussing, no nothing. Preaching and singing and enjoying my life. Hallelujah. 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 Praise God. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you. This blessing you gave to your people. Nobody gave these words but God Himself. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make His face to shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up His countenance upon thee and give thee shalom. God bless you.
Something in your eyes, something in